Welcome back to Investor Intel. We have a new guest today. Old company, new guest. Say hello to Nic Earner from Alkane Resources.
G'day, how are you going?
Very well. How are you today?
No, really good. Really good. Really good, thanks.
Where are you today?
I'm in Perth, where our company's head office is, and I'm just about to fly out to Singapore tonight to the Metal Events Conference.
Were you planning on coming up to Toronto for the mining show in March?
Perhaps the first quarter of next year is pretty fluid at the moment because we think we'll have a fair bit going on corporately at that time.
Good. Well, let's talk about that. We sat with Ian at the Clean Tech Metal Show last May, and he gave us an outline of the company. Being a gold guy from Northern Ontario, I'm always very interested in the gold project, but there's more to Alkane than just gold. So let's talk about Dubbo.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, so our Dubbo project is pretty well developed in that we've got the government permits all squared away, which is a pretty big challenge in most Western jurisdictions. But that's a big project of that we'll be producing zirconium, hafnium, niobium, and a whole suite of rare metals, including yttrium. All the way, most of the magnet metals will come out of this plant.
Now, there was a lot of excitement about hafnium at the Clean Tech Show last May. And honestly, I have a science background. It was the first time I heard anything substantive about hafnium. So what's the magic with hafnium?
Oh, look, people are excited about hafnium because there's two sort of diverging uses for it. One is that people are looking at it particularly on computer chips as an incredibly fast silicon replacement on computer chips. That's one area. So there's a fair bit of technology going on in that space, much, much more than I understand, to be perfectly honest. And then the other thing is on turbines and particularly jet turbine engines, people are putting hafnium into their alloys to lower the amount of distortion and thermal creep that's occurring in those engines. And so
that's an existing use, right? That's not a new use. That's existing.
It's an existing use. And I think as far as we can ascertain, it's a use where people are waiting for a decent, stable supplier. If you think of these aerospace companies, and indeed some of these technology companies, no one wants to introduce a metal into their product range where they're going to have supply shortages. They need that problem like a hole in the head. You know, they want a stable supply of a metal before that they can start to add into their long-term product suite.
Right. So I was curious about the hafnium, but you also have zirconium. And what else in that deposit?
Well, we have zirconium, and then we have a whole range of rare earth metals, and we also have niobium.
Which is in short supply, and people are saying the use will increase with electric vehicles.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
All right, so that's Dubbo. Let's do the gold project now. The gold is near and dear my heart. How's the gold doing?
Yeah, really well. We've been really excited about the productivity we've got out of that plant. Yeah, unfortunately, it's a small resource, right? And we finish our open cut mining there about this time next year. So we'll be finishing mining in the July, August, September quarter next year in 2018. Right. And then at the moment, we're doing a whole heap of drilling for extensions under it, looking really promising. And we're saying to ourselves, okay, do we or don't we go underground there now? Or do we build up more of our regional exploration? We've got quite a lot of great tenements around it. But do we build up the resource base and then go again? We've got an excellent capital infrastructure there.
You've been in revenue. You haven't really had to do that large financing. The gold has been paying for some of the other operations.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So we've got a bit over 50 million Australian dollars, you know, very, really close to Canadian dollars in the bank at present. We've got no significant outflows. We've got more revenue coming in over at least the next 12 months from the gold business. And we've financed all the environmental permitting, you know, continued to do extensive pilot work on Dubbo. And we've done a lot of engineering, you know, more than $10 million of engineering, feed study, bankable level, modularization studies. So, yeah, we've done that out of cash flow and continue to do explorer. Because at our heart, we're a company that explores, finds deposits, and slowly brings them into production or sells them.
Right. Yeah. Now, you're relatively new to the company. How did you come to join Alkane?
Yeah, so I joined Alkane 4 years ago as the company was about halfway through construction of the gold business. The company was becoming an operator again from being explorer. And so my background is all about operations, construction, commissioning, you know, turnaround stuff.
engineer.
And so that's how. Yeah, I'm a chemical engineer. Been in the game now for over 20 years, and yeah, a big chunk of my time was actually spent for Western Mining, who got taken over by BHP Billiton at the big Olympic Dam copper gold deposit in South Australia. And yeah, and so you know, when I met Ian Chalmers, you know, we just had one of those happy intersections of you know, right place, right time, right sort of skill set. So I'd spent a lot of time in open cut and underground gold, but as well as that, I'd spent a lot of time in solvent extraction, advanced metal extraction, particularly with uranium, leaching, roasting, smelting, all courtesy of Olympic Dam. And so, yeah, really fitted in nicely with the Dubbo project as well.
So you're able to take that knowledge with you. But I thought you were more recent to the company. You just said you've been there 4 years?
Yeah, 4 years. So I was the chief operations officer beforehand and basically formed the company's operating division again, and then also picked up all the project and engineering work and do a lot of the government liaison and all the important but sometimes complex and a little bit frustrating things. Yeah.
I had that kind of day today at the office, 1,000 little things, not one of them important on their own, but God help you if you forget any one of them.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's hard to commission a plant. So what's on the horizon?
Yeah, look, the really, really big thing for us is squaring away the financing for the Dubbo project. We have some product development we're doing. We continue to refine our products to make them more appealing or matching with customers, in particular in the specialty zirconia space, and so we're continue to do some work on hafnium. But the big thing is our project sits ready to execute. I have the permission, if I have the money, I have the permission to start construction tomorrow. So I could do that.
What is your CapEx for the construction?
Well, our original project, if we go for fully permitted, which we would process 1 million tonnes per annum of ore, was $1.3 billion Australian dollars, so $1 billion US. And we've spent a lot of time in the last year working out how to modularise and stage build that capacity so that our financial risk for ourselves and investors can be built across four trains. And at the moment, we're looking at a $650 to $700 million doing first half in two stages, so that most investors want to see us come into production, produce successfully, establish a market for our products, and then get the right revenue in the market. And then they can say, okay, now right. I can put more money
and
in
then
with less risk.
Up after.
Exactly, exactly. So our big focus is getting on that first bit of funding, which is the first half of that $650, $700 million, laying down one train, commissioning it, proving it, and then going again. And obviously the shift of do we sell a part of the project, do we do equity, do we do debt, that all changes depending on you know, the revenue percentage and which stage of that ramp up you're in.
Well, Alkane is always at the top of our list. I have all kinds of respect for Mr. Chalmers, found him educational, entertaining, and if you come up for the Clean Tech Show and maybe we can have a beverage together.
That'll be great. Always keen.
Looking forward to it. Have a good day.
Right. Thank you very much.
Bye.